Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah. Ashhadu an la
لا إلا الله وأدناها إماطة الأذى عن الطريق والحياء شعبة من الإيمان رواه البخاري. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, for the last few weeks we are trying to understand from the role model of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam our role in the community that is we are living in, a non-Muslim community. Of course, any role we play, it has to start with the Muslim community, because all charities begin at home. Every good has to be started with ourselves. Every change we want to bring in the society, we have to be the reason for that change. And we learned a lot from the role model of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who for a period of 40 years before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him to be the last and final prophet and to be the recipient of the last testament, that is the Holy Quran, which was the only divine scripture which was guaranteed the preservation from all kind of distortions. We learned how he was involved in his non-Muslim community. We have learned how he was not only feeding the poor, helping the elderly, helping the weak, taking the burden from the old people. He was the one who was the reason for change in Arabia. One person, but this one person was described in the glorious words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as mercy for the entire universe. إِنَّ وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself, he said, إِنَّمَا أَنَا رَحْمَةٌ مُهْدَى. I am a gift of the mercy to the entire universe, you know, to the humanity and to all the members of all the societies in living anywhere in the world. We learned from the witness of the first Muslim, and for your information, first Muslim was a woman, that was Sayyida Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, who spoke about. So let me just go to the last part of her saying. Now we have covered every word before that. We have analyzed that and we have gone into various aspects of the biography, seerah, and the life of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Last thing she said was, وَتُعِينُ عَلَى نَوَائِبِ الْحَقِّ. And you help on the نَوَائِبِ الْحَقِّ. What is نَوَائِبِ الْحَقِّ? النَوَائِبِ in Arabic language, الْحَوَادِثِ خَيْرًا كَانَتْ أَوْ شَرًا. Whatever the humanity is hit with, it may be natural disasters, it may be accidents, it may be sicknesses, it may be anything that touches a human being. And according to Islam, whatever hits a believer is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. And for a believer, a test never turns a believer into a person with ingratitude. On the contrary, a believer will return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this dua and begging that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide me to firmly stand and go through this test. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was going into his community, and anybody who needed any kind of help, he was providing. And the Holy Quran came later on telling the entire humankind in Surah number 5, Suratul Ma'idah, verse number 2, وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. And it's imperative command. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses imperative command, according to the jurist and according to the scholars, it amounts to becoming a faridah. It is an obligation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you cooperate. Anything that is birr. And if you want to know the detailed description of birr, read Suratul Baqarah, Surah number 2, verse number 177. Which has not only included almost all five pillars of Islam, but also it teaches us that at the time of the natural disasters, at the time of the masaib and calamities, and we are hit on a daily basis by those calamities. You know, latest episode of that, what happened in Jerusalem. We are not going to go into those details, but we need to go into the detail that how can we bring change. Change across the communities in America, and change which will bring by the grassroots, by that social work which we did not do in these communities, that will reflect into the change on the authorities and the politicians. So we are continuing to be hit one way or the other, one day or the other day, by some new calamities, and all those calamities take us to the glorious words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. These negatives which are hitting us, they will not be changed unless we bring the change in our own self. Unless we follow the footsteps of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, unless we realize that there is no room in Islam for selfishness. You know, I have just recited Surah number 103, Suratul Asr, about which Sayyidina Imam Shafi'i, rahimahullahu rahmatan wasi'a, he said, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not reveal the rest of the Holy Quran, if he only revealed Suratul Asr, lakafat, it would have been sufficient for the guidance of the humanity. And here, not only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taking an oath with Alasr. What is Alasr? It is the time which has passed from the beginning of this universe till today. That past time, or if you take another opinion, It is, if you compare the existence of this universe, we have reached up to the Asr time. What is left is much shorter than what has gone according to the supreme plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, by Al-Asr, taking an oath with the word, the time that has passed. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ. Surely, the humankind are in gross loss. That khasara and loss, which is connected to the humanity. Anyone who would like to go into the detail and a deeper knowledge, you can return and read the history of the humankind. You will see that the vast majority of the humankind are spoken about in this verse that they were in gross loss. Because no matter how much material wealth you have in this world, if you do not have the spiritual wealth, if you do not have the connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that material wealth may be beneficial for you in this temporary life, but it is not going to be beneficial in everlasting life after death. And in there, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has exempted four things. No. When I used to study in Alasr University, my MA thesis was on this surah. The title was Bina'ul Mujtama'il Misali Fi Daw'i Surat Al-Asr. How we can found an exemplary community in the light of Surat Al-Asr, because it is so complete, it has covered everything that is written in the Holy Quran in 114 chapters and over 6,000 verses. So the first one, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Iman is the reason for bringing out from the loss which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking about. And only iman is not going to help. There may be other tradition where people say, believe it and you will be saved. But in Islam, there is no such thing. You read through the Holy Quran, wherever iman is mentioned, al-amalu salih is connected with that. Illa alladhina amanu wa amilu salihat. You have to translate your faith into your behavior, into your relationship, into your interaction with your own families, with your neighbors, and with the humanity at large. And in order to do that, you have to go steps forward. You are not allowed to be a selfish person. Like if somebody says, oh, I have faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and I am practicing, so it's going to be sufficient for me. No, it's not going to be sufficient for us. Why? Because in Mishkat, one of the hadith book, which is a collection from the other books of the hadith, there is a hadith where Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was speaking about a particular people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the angels that go to such and such town and destroy that town. So the angel said, Ya Allah, in that particular town, there is a very pious person.
He is a very righteous. He never ever disobeyed you. You know what was the answer? The answer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was, take him first. Take him first. And put the town on top of him. Because he was the one who thought, my self-righteousness is going to save me. It is sufficient for my, you know, najat or my safety. No, it is not. That is why the remaining two part, وَتَوَاصَوْ بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْ بِالصَّبْرِ التَّوَاصِي بِالْحَقِّ and التَّوَاصِي بِالصَّبْرِ is the part of the deal. When you say, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, the contract which you are signing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah says in chapter 5 verse 1, أَوْفُ بِالْعُقُودِ. The declaration of faith is a contract with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As getting married is a contract between the couple. Going to work is a contract for action and for work. Being a student is a contract also. So we have multiple kind of contracts which we have to fulfill. And you have to go through the clauses of the contract. سَيَ الْإِيمَانِ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. What is the meaning of that? With that message, today we have 1.8 billion followers. And those people who were trained on the hands of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they did not form ghetto mentality or the ghetto community where everybody kullu hizbin bima ladayhim farihun. No, they came out. They gave sacrifices. They dispersed in the entire universe. Why? Once you say Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, you become a messenger of God Almighty. A messenger who will be following the messenger of the messenger of Allah. That was the word Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used about Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu, when he sent him as a governor of Yemen, and he asked him, if you are faced with a difficulty and you don't find the solution in the Quran and Sunnah, what are you going to do? So he said, in the light of Quran and Sunnah, I will use my intellect and I will come to the conclusion. On that, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was very happy. And he said that word, that with the translation of that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided the messenger of messenger to say what was the right thing. And this is how waqadish طرط الله للنجاة بعد الإيمان والعمل الصالح التواصي بالحق والتواصي بالصبر وبين أن كمال الإنسان في نفسه لا يكفي حتى يسعى إلى كمال غيره حتى يسعى إلى كمال غيره. وفي هذا دلالة أن الفرد ليس وحدة كاملة في مجتمعه بل هو جزء من الوحدة والوحدة هي المجتمع والجماعة بل على تعبير الحديث النبوي هي الجسد الذي إذا اشتكى منه عضو تداعت له سائر الأعضاء بالسهر والحمى. فكما لا ينبغي
أن يكون الفرد ناقصا لا ينبغي أن يكون غيره في المجتمع ناقصا. What is the meaning of that? The meaning of that is it is not sufficient to have the self-righteousness. It is the duty and responsibility across the humanity to continue to move forward, continue to bring the reforms, continue to fulfill the duties and responsibilities. And that is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in another hadith, let us conclude with that word because the time is up. He said, La yakmul imanu ahadikum hatta yuhibba li akhihi ma yuhibbu li nafsih. Until your iman will not be perfect unless you love, you desire, you wish for others what you desire for yourself. At-tawasi bil-haq wa at-tawasi bil-sabr are two pillars. After al-iman wal-amal as-salih, that you continue to share the beauties of the messages of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And at-tawasi bil-sabr means you continue to patiently persevere because you are going to face many different kind of difficulties. So let us all pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us firmness in standing and playing the role which we are required to play, no matter where we are, in our own countries, in non-Muslim countries, in any community, we are part of that human society. Any bad come to the human society will eventually hit us too. And any good, and the Muslims have to bring that good which will come, it will be for the good of the humanity. There is a request for dua of the shifa and recovery from the sickness for the brother Mirsan Ibrahim, and dua for the maghfirah for the brother Muhsin ibn Abdullah Jubayri. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant speedy recovery to all sick people, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant his maghfirah to all those who have passed away. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'il al muslimin fastaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إرغاما لمن جحد به وكفر، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله سيد الخلائق والبشر. قال الله تبارك وتعالى: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد بعدد من صلى وسلم، وصل على محمد وعلى آل محمد بعدد من قعد وقام، وصل على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين والصحابة أجمعين والتابعين وتبع التابعين وسلف الصالحين وأولياء الكاملين وعلماء الراسخين إلى يوم الدين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه، اللهم وحد كلمة المسلمين، اللهم ألف بين قلوب المؤمنين، اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين، اللهم وفقنا إلى كل ما تحبه وترضاه من القول والعمل يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر لجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم، ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى. و
وَأَعَزُّ وَجَلُّ وَهَمُّ وَأَتَمُّ وَأَعْظَمُ وَأَكْبَرُ فَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ مَا تَصْنَعُونَ أَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.